Hey everyone, I'm Herrick Kimmel, and 4 years after making one of my early YouTube videos in which I showed how to use this tool to pull a T-post, I am back, not to show this tool again, but to answer a question that I got on that video yesterday. And the question was, it's actually not a question, it's a statement. My problem is getting the post in the ground when it's nothing but rocks. Well, today in this video, I'm going to show you how to set a T-post easily by first making a pocket hole or a pilot hole, you might call it if you're an ex-carpenter like I am, in the soil with a bar. And I've done this for many years. It makes the job of setting a few T-posts very easy. Okay, so the tool that you need, the tool you want, the tool you must have to make a good pocket hole for your T-post prior to driving it in the ground is a bar like this. I call it a digging bar. There may be other names. This is 5 foot long. It is 17 pounds. It says 18 right here, but I just weighed it. It's 17. Maybe I've worn a pound off it over the years. I bought this when I was in my 20s, and I'm in my 60s now. So that gives you an idea how long I've had this. It's a tool I love. It's a tool that every homestead should have. I want you to see here that it's wedge shaped. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to make a pocket hole for my T-post right here, right in front of me. And the soil is kind of moist, which helps a lot. And I'm just going to drop the bar right where I want it to be. And I want you to know that the V shape is going like this, okay? I'm going to make a hole for the T-post by moving the bar back and forth like that, okay? Now, if I drove this, I could feel a rock right there, but I just drove right by it. If you hit a big rock and you feel that vibration right up through your elbows, you know that you're not gonna go through it with the bar. So you need to move a little, one way or the other, a couple inches. All right, usually that's perfectly acceptable. So I'm dropping that bar in there and I'm going back and forth. And I felt another stone. You could feel the stone. And I just, by wedging it, I caught that stone and I went this way and I moved that stone right out of the way. Okay, so I'm not using a lot of strength to drive this in the ground. I'm letting that 17 pounds do the work. And I'm using a little bit of strength to go side to side. All right, now I have, in this instance, a 6 foot T-post, and I like to put my T-posts 1.5 feet in the ground. And I don't know if you can see them behind me here, I have some bush planted raspberries where I used these T-posts, 6 foot long, 1.5 feet in the ground. What's that, 4.5 feet above ground. Now on this digging bar, I know that right about here, it starts to taper to round from square. And I know that a handhold below that is about 1.5 feet. Let's see. Yeah, it's right on. So, all right, I'm down enough and I've made my pocket hole. So once you've made that pocket hole with the digging bar, it's easy to get the post in. In fact, it might be so easy that you hardly have to pound it at all. All you've got to do is set it in there and give it a couple bops with a sledgehammer, and then you can pound the soil around it. If you had some rocks, stones that you wanted to drive down beside the post, you could put them there and drive them down with your feet. I used to use a sledgehammer to drive T-posts, and then a few years ago, as I'm getting up in years, I splurged for a T-post pounder like this. And these are a very handy tool, kind of like that, the puller. It's one of those tools that makes all the difference. Okay, this was a really easy pocket hole to make. And I'm going to now show you how to make a pocket hole in a very difficult situation, just to underscore that that digging bar is the way to do this. Okay, this is my driveway. It is a dense packed stone, several inches deep, maybe 6 inches deep. So this is a good demonstration. We're talking stones here. And it's going to take some time. I'll probably speed this up, but this is going to work for me. And we'll come up closer now, and you can get the front row view. Okay, well, it took me a few minutes and I got sweat dripping off the end of my nose, but I had to prove a point. Not that you're ever gonna do this, but I'm my foot and a half down. It's stone most of the way, more than a foot and a half. Can you see that pocket in there? Yeah. Yeah, I'll try to drive in my post, even with the wings on it, the wings. Okay, we get the old handy Andes on here. Drop our post in. Get our pounder. Loud, isn't it? Good enough. Well, that is a little crooked, but if I were doing this for an actual application where this was needed and I was being persnickety, which I usually am, I would straighten this up by kicking stone in on this side and maybe even bending it over. Whoa, look at that. We're almost good. Okay. Well, that was my morning workout and my demonstration that a digging bar is the tool to have when you want to set T-posts without a lot of discouragement and every single time. You know, get yourself a pilot hole. Thank you very much for watching. Hey, give me a like if you liked this demonstration and subscribe to my channel if you're not already. You never know what you're going to get here. I'm Eric Kimball signing off. Bye-bye.